The average physically inactive man loses close to 1% of muscle mass each year after turning 30. This is also the point after which we typically start to gain fat more easily. And the worst thing about that is that the longer we take to get rid of it, the more and more stubborn it becomes. Now, a classical scapegoat we used to use in the past would be our slower post-30 metabolism. But the latest research shows that our metabolism doesn't change that much until we reach 60. The truth is that the main thing that changes as we grow older is that we move less and less and that we eat more and more, when we should be doing the opposite. Yet, somewhere around our 30s is the point where we start to live a more sedentary lifestyle. We begin working longer hours, we stress eat, we spend more time sitting at desks and commuting to work. And because of all the extra responsibilities that come up, we have less time to move and exercise than ever before. Another common mistake that a lot of us do after this point is that we try to work out in the same way that we used to in our early 20s. So the moment we have an opening in our weekly schedule, we try to defuse all the pent-up stress from all the week, make up for all the lost workouts and extra calories consumed by rushing through our warm-up and blasting our joints with a hardcore workout. And maybe this go hard or go home mindset works for a while, and maybe it used to work during an earlier decade. It's definitely the way I used to think when I was younger, but eventually our bodies begin to give us signs that this is not an optimal way to do things anymore. Maybe it starts with a little discomfort in our knees or our lower back or one of our elbows, one of our shoulders. Whatever the case though, our body gradually begins to experience the consequences. So instead of changing the way we train, we usually just find it more convenient to accept that this is how things are, and we either let go slowly or we train until something breaks down or needs surgery. But what if instead of slowly wearing out our joints and connective tissues and other parts of our bodies that we unfortunately don't have spares for, we instead adapt the way that we train based on our busier lifestyle and how our bodies are gradually beginning to change? What if a little quality work on a daily basis is a smarter and more balanced way to stay active, to manage stress better, and to stay strong, lean, and healthy as we grow older? What if instead of becoming the classic beer belly type of dad, you stay the fit dad? What if instead of feeling like 50 when you're 30, as a lot of men nowadays feel, you instead become that guy at the park knocking out push-ups, looking like 30 when you're in reality in your mid-40s? Enter high-frequency calisthenics. High-frequency calisthenics is a system that I've been developing the last 6 years. It's what I've been using to get in my best shape of my life, even though I'm past my mid-30s. It's a system I've been using to successfully train other people over 30. And it's a system that I'm happy to say I'm finally ready to share with the rest of the world. For those of you who don't know me, my name is Anthony Arvanitakis. The reason my last name sounds a little bit weird is because I'm Greek. I'm a graduate from the Aristotle University of Sports Science and Physical Education, from which I've also received awards for my successful career as a coach here. I'm an author of best-selling books such as Bodyweight Muscle, and getting in shape without lifting weights or using fancy machines has been my passion the last decade. After an accident in my early 20s that cost me my left leg, left me depressed and in the worst shape of my life, I got obsessed with bodyweight training, and I managed to turn things around by creating a positive and healthy lifestyle with calisthenics at the epicenter of it. High frequency calisthenics are for you if you've been struggling to see any serious results ever since you crossed that 30s, 40s, or 50s threshold and you feel that your body is starting to work more and more against you than with you. If fat around your waist seems to become more and more stubborn and challenging to get rid of, if long training sessions seem to zap too much energy from you, if training with heavy weights is starting to take a toll on your body, and you're ready to try something new, if you prefer having a practical workout plan that you can do anywhere and anytime, no matter what's going on in your life or the rest of the world, And a workout plan you can do either outdoors in the fresh air, at your backyard, your apartment, or even in your basement where no one can find you. The reason I'm making this video is in order to share with you that there's a lot better way to train and stay in great shape after 30 and give you all the basic guidelines required in order to get started on such a plan. Also, for those interested in something more, I want to invite you the coming months to train beside me and join a tribe of men post 30 that are not only interested in getting great shape, but also want to use that physical boost in order to create more healthy habits and to bring more balance in their lives. So make sure that you don't miss the next videos where I'll be sharing with you how to set up a high frequency calisthenics plan. I'll be also including a newsletter below where you can subscribe and make sure you stay posted every time one of these videos goes online. You'll also receive there a summarized version of the video with all the practical steps and some extra tips. In the next video, I'll be sharing with you all the benefits of high frequency calisthenics. We'll be talking a little bit about the science behind it, how to get started with it, and some common pitfalls that you want to avoid. That was all for today. If you have any questions, make sure that you leave them below. And until next time, as I like to say, keep on training.